Hello everyone, Good Shepherds High School, Belapur. Welcome you all for online learning session. Standard 7th, Subject General Science, Unit 1, Topic The Living World, Adaptations and Classification. Dear children, today we will learn first lesson of Standard 7th, The Living World, Adaptations and Classification. Let's recall. In what different ways is the diversity in living things seen? Diversity means different criteria. The diversity in the living things is seen due to their different shape, size, color, and different structure of the body. Okay, children? A great variety of plants is found on the earth. Some plants have colorful flowers, some plants grow in water, whereas some are to be found in deserts which have a scarcity of water. Some plants are found only in snowy region. Some plants cannot be seen without a microscope, whereas some are huge in size. So children, there are many diversity in plants. Let me do it short for you. Diversity in plants, you will get first flowering plants, non-flowering plants. Second, plants growing in water, in deserts, in snowy regions. Third, microscopic plants, huge plants. So these are the diversity in plants. And diversity in animals, unicellular means single celled, multicellular means many celled. Second, invertebrates and vertebrates. Third, aquatic, terrestrial, amphibian, reptilian, aerial. These are the diversities in plants and animals. So, can you tell, are the plants and animals from Kashmir and Rajasthan of the same type? Can you elaborate on any differences between the two? Children, Kashmir and Rajasthan, they are very different parts. So, they are asking, are the plants and animals from Kashmir and Rajasthan of the same type? No, obvious no. Kashmir and Rajasthan are geographically different terrains, places. Their climatic conditions are also different in these two places. Therefore, the flora means all the plants and fauna, all the animals, is also different. Animals in Kashmir are with thick fur. Their body is changed to suit the cold climate. Rajasthan being the desert, animals like camel are seen here. According to local conditions, the plants and animals show different characteristics. Okay, students. Next, coniferous trees like pine and deodar flourish in snowy regions like Kashmir. Why? Because coniferous trees are like the pine trees are how? They are sloping like downwards. However, in the desert of Rajasthan, plants like cactus and acacia, babul, are to be found. The camel, a desert animal, is not found in Kashmir. What is the reason for these differences? The reason is adaptation. In snowy region, there are coniferous trees like pine and deodar. Example, Kashmir. In desert, plants like cactus and acacia babul are seen. Example, Rajasthan. The camel, being a desert animal, cannot inhabit colder region of Kashmir. Okay. Now, adaptation means what? See. Adaptation. Gradual changes occur in the body parts and also in the behavior of organisms which help them to adjust to their surroundings. Such changes are called adaptations. They take place over a long period of time. Okay, students. Now, adaptation in plants. Observe and complete the chart. Plant habitat means place of means where they survive. Habitat means place for living. Type of root, characteristics of leaves, characteristics of stem. Now lotus habitat is aquatic, because lotus you find in ponds. Types of root is fibrous. Characteristics of leaves, what are the main features of lotus? Of leaves, what are the features of leaves of lotus? Large and round with waxy layer. And what are the characteristics of stem? Hollow and flexible. Next, cactus habitat, desert. Type of root, deeply penetrating inside the sand. Characteristics of leaves, cannot see leaves. Characteristics of stem, thick, fleshy, green stem. Now banyan habitat, land. Type of root, some in soil, some aerial. Banyan tree. Yeah? Characteristics of leaves, big and green. And characteristics of stem, hard, tall. Okay, children. Now, adaptation in aquatic plants. Visit various water bodies such as a river, brook, pond, lake in your surroundings. What differences do you observe between terrestrial and aquatic plants? Yes, children. What changes you see? That will be homework for you. Some of the aquatic plants are firmly rooted in the soil at the bottom of the water bodies. Now see this 1.2 aquatic plants. I will read for you all from this paragraph only. It is adaptation in aquatic plants. Firmly rooted in soil and submerged stems. Correct. Some plants entirely afloat with floating roots, while some submerged in water. Stems and petioles are soft, flexible. Leaves and flowers float on water. Some plants have thin ribbon shaped slender leaves. This is an adaptation to withstand fast currents of water. Next, leaves and stems coated with waxy layer and air spaces inside the stem and leaves, and they are all adapted for floating. Okay, children, this is a adaptation in aquatic plants. Okay, now use your brain power. What does water trickle off lotus leaves? Why does water trickle off lotus leaves? Why it trickles off lotus leaves? Lotus is an aquatic plant that has a coating of waxy layer on its stems and leaves. If water falls on the leaves, it is not absorbed but gets trickled down. Okay, children, you got the answer? Yes. Next, why don't the leaves of these plants rot in water? Why? What is the reason? The leaves of aquatic plants have waxy coating on them. There are no stomata on the leaves. and thus water cannot enter the leaves. Therefore, the leaves do not rot in water. Children, these questions I am going to ask in the exams. Why are their roots short and fibrous? What is the reason, children? The main function of the roots is to hold the plant firmly and to absorb water and minerals for the plant. Both of these functions are not needed for the plant like lotus, which floats on the water. Therefore, their roots are short and fibrous. Got it? Now, adaptation in desert plants. See this. Leafless or leaves like small needles. Some leaves seem to be modified into thorns for conserving water. Very little water is lost by evaporation. Next, the stems are fleshy as water and food is stored in them. Modified stems perform photosynthesis and hence are green. There are modified stems, but they are green. Why? Because photosynthesis takes place in it. Thorn-like leaves do not perform photosynthesis. Their roots are deeply penetrated. Why? In search of water and thick layer of a waxy substance on the stems. This is a adaptation in desert plants. Got it, children? Next, adaptation in plants of snowy regions. Can you tell in what way are sloping branches useful to plants in a snowy region? See how the sloping branches are there. The reason is the snow should naturally fall from the branches and should not remain on the tree top. Therefore, as an adaptation, the plants in a snowy region have sloping branches. This question can come for the exam. Let me repeat again. The snow should naturally fall off from the branches and should not remain on the tree top. Therefore, as an adaptation, the plants in a snowy region have sloping branches. This is a deodar tree there. Let me explain more. Conifers like deodar and pine are seen in snowy region. One more tree, pine tree. Trees are conical in shape with sloping branches. Due to heavy snowfall and extreme cold weather, such adaptations are seen. Conical shape prevents the accumulation. Accumulation means collection of snow on the tree. Thick bark helps the tree to withstand the cold. The thick bark, a cover of tree, of a pine and deodar, it helps to withstand the cold. Now, adaptation in plants of forest regions. See the forest, such a big jungle. Now, what do you find adaptation in forest region? Let me explain you. A diverse variety of plants, trees, shrubs and herbs are seen in the forest. All the plants compete among themselves for sunlight. Hence, trees grow tall to get sunlight, and climbers and vines grow to a great height with the support of trees. Climbers have adapted by having spring-like tendrils with which they seek support from host tree, main tree. So this is an adaptation in plants of forest regions. Now, adaptation in grassland plants. Children, bushes and grasses of diverse types are seen in grasslands. Soil erosion is prevented by fibrous roots of grasses. Very tall grasses are seen in the equatorial region. Animals like tiger, elephants, and deer take shelter in these grasses. Very short grasses grow in cold regions. Smaller animals like the rabbits are seen in such short grasses. Vast meadows are found in plains and hilly areas. This is the adaptation in grassland plants. Okay, children, I'm giving you all point by point. You have to understand it. Okay. Here one more line is there. Fibrous roots of grasses prevent soil erosion. Always remember. Forests in the equatorial regions are dense. Dense means full bhara hua. Observe and discuss. Observe and note down the adaptation in parts of plants like potato, groundnut, yam, water hyacinth, aloe, acacia, carrot, onion, beet, bitter gourd, grapevine, etc. and other plants in your surroundings. Sorry. This is the activity for you all. Adaptation for ingestion of food in plants. Adaptation for ingestion of food in plants. Now I will read this. This is the whole paragraph. I will convert it into points. First point. Most of the plants are autotrophic. Some plants are parasitic, example dodder, cuscuta, which is leafless and thus cannot perform photosynthesis. Cuscuta, see. There are hostorial roots for sucking and absorbing nutrients from the host plant. It grows on a host plant, main plant, no? There they take support of it. Fungi cannot perform photosynthesis as they lack chlorophyll, and they obtain food from starchy foodstuffs. Root-like fibers are present in them for absorption of food. Next, plants like Drosera, sundew, Venus flytrap, pitcher plant, etc. consume insects to fulfill their need for nitrogen. They need nitrogen for consuming. The plants in nitrogen deficient are usually insectivorous plants. Such plants have structural adaptations to attract insects and hold them captive. Means adaptations are seen in these plants which serve, they attract all insects and directly they eat, and they hold them captive, means directly close their mouth and they start eating. Okay. Now, children, adaptation in animals. Adaptation in animals. The aquatic animals show modified structure of body. Tapering spindle shaped body with scales and fins for swimming. Respiration by gills. Air bladders within the body for floating. Now see this. Observe the bodies of the frog, duck and tortoise. Of what use are their legs to these animals? All the three animals, that is the frog, duck and tortoise, use their legs for locomotion, means to walk, and swimming. Okay, next question. What helps frogs to breathe underwater? When in water frogs breathe with the help of skin. Okay children, next. Of what use are the long hind legs of a frog? When on land, frog uses its hind legs for jumping. When in water, the same legs are used for swimming as oars. Why doesn't a duck get wet in water? Water floats off from the waxy layer of feathers, and thus duck does not get wet even in water. Got it? Let me repeat it again. Water flows off from the waxy layer of feathers, and thus duck does not get wet even in water. Yes children, as the frog and duck have webbed toes, they can use their legs like oars, no? I just now explained. Now, adaptation. In forest and grassland animals. Here are the adaptations in forest and grassland animals. Children, carnivorous animals, you all know, those who eat flesh like wild dog, fox, tiger and lion. They have strong legs to run fast and capture their prey. Prey matlab shikar. They have claws and their canine teeth are sharp and pointed. What is the function of such teeth? They tear the meat and all and eat. Tigers have padded paws. This enables them to silently stalk their prey and capture it easily. You must have seen Animal Planet. The eyes of predatory carnivores are located in the front of their head. It helps them to spot their prey from a long distance. The eye of herbivores are below the forehead, on either side of the head. This gives them wide angle vision, which helps to protect them from predators. See, nature has made, no? Kind of a nature. See, their legs are long and tapering with strong hooves, which enables them to run fast, taking long leaps like black buck. Their long and freely moving ears can receive sounds from long distances and different directions. Deer and black bucks have colors that merge with their surroundings. Their teeth are strong for chewing tough plant materials. This is the adaptation in forest and grassland animals. Now, adaptation in desert animals. I'll explain here. Severe scarcity of water has resulted into adaptation in the body of animals. Second point is burrowing in deep earth, remaining dormant at daytime and active at night. daytime dormant means sleeping, and active at night. Characteristics in camel. See, long legs with flat and cushioned soles. See, cushioned soles. Folds of skin over the nostrils. Long and thick eyelashes. Thick skin to conserve water in the body. Example, rats, snakes, spiders, lizards in desert. So this is the adaptation in desert animals. These are all desert animals. Ooh. Now, adaptation in animals of snowy regions. Long, thick hair on the skin. White or silver body color. Example, yak, polar bear, white fox, silver fox, mountain goat, Siberian husky dog, and snow leopard. Okay, children, the adaptation in animals of snowy region. They are long and thick hair on the skin and white or silver body color. Okay, next is, can you tell what is the main difference between vehicles on the road and aeroplanes? What is the difference? Vehicles have wheels and aeroplane has wings. Aeroplanes have wings and vehicles on the road have wheels. Correct, no? This is the main difference between road and aeroplanes. Now, adaptation in birds. Means aerial animals means birds, children. Okay? See, spindle-shaped body of birds, all that minimize the resistance of air while flying. Feathers covering the body. Four legs modified into wings. Air sac in the body to increase buoyancy. Buoyancy means to fly, you know. It's very easy to fly, like they can jump here and there and fly also, bouncy. Hollow bones making body light in weight and adapted for flying. Their bones are very hollow. If you'll catch any bird, no, you just see. Sparrow also. Their legs are very hollow. Adaptation in insects. Light-weighted and tapering body. Two pairs of wings for flight. Six stick-like walking legs. This is for insects. Now, adaptations in bat. Thin fold of skin called patagium between their forelegs and hind legs. Lightweight and ability to hang. You have seen the bat, how they hang themselves. Okay. Observe the various birds and insects in your area. You better watch Animal Planet. You will come to know. If you will read this and if you will watch, no, it will be cleared very soon. Adaptation in reptiles. Oh, reptiles. Snakes creep with the help of scales on their skin. These are the scales. Some reptiles use their muscles for creeping. Example, house lizard, garden lizard, crocodile. Okay. Skin and soles of feet are specially modified for creeping mode. They creep. Example, house lizard and monitor lizards. Ariva, there are also monitors. How in the class? Same way in the lizard also. Body color shows camouflage to hide with the surrounding. Camouflage means their skin is similar to the surrounding to hide themselves. See, sometimes this lizards on the wall, you will never see that they are there. Why? Because the camouflage is there, no? Means their skin is a color and their this body color is somehow similar. So it is quite difficult to recognize that they are there or no. Okay, next, adaptation in reptiles finished. Adaptation for food in animals. Children, as you know, animals are either herbivorous and carnivorous. Herbivorous means vegetarian, carnivorous non-vegetarian. And few are omnivorous, means they are both, like me. Means herbivorous, those who eat vegetables also and meat also. According to their feeding, there are some special adaptations. See, they are saying, watch the program of channels like National Geographic, Wild Discovery, etc. to learn about feeding habits and animals like frogs, snakes, birds, mosquitoes, butterflies, etc. We can't bring in the school, right? Now, these are the adaptation, animal and use of adaptation. Sharp teeth. Which animal? Lion, tiger. This will be coming for your exam, children. Use of adaptation to tear the flesh. That's why they have sharp teeth. Long and pointed beak. Kingfisher, crane, animals. Use of adaptation to capture the fish in water. Short beak, sparrow, to peck the grain. Use of adaptation to peck the grain. Long and sticky tongue, animals, garden lizard, frog. What use of adaptation is? To catch the insect. Long neck, giraffe, emu, ostrich. In birds, to have a long distance gazing, and giraffe to eat leaves from the top of the tree. This is the complete chart of adaptation, animals and use of adaptation. Okay, children. Now, adaptation for blending with the surroundings. Ghul mil jana, surrounding mein, adaptations. Let me read. Adaptations are the changes that take place in the various organs and life processes of organisms, so as to enable them to live, feed, reproduce and protect themselves from their enemies in specific habitat and its geographical conditions. Adaptations is a gradual and continuous process. The structure and appearance of present day animals and animals of thousands of years ago are different from each other. This is due to the adaptations that occurred in them to suit the prevailing condition, chalu conditions. We must conserve this diversity, children. Okay, that is called adaptation. Now, always remember, yes, I read this also. Now, Darwin's theory. Charles Darwin, a biologist, studied numerous types of plants and animals and suggested that only those organisms are likely to survive which can best adapt themselves to a changing environment. This is called the theory of survival of the fittest. This is Darwin's first principle. Now, theory of natural selection. If an organism is born with a new beneficial characteristics and is able to survive, this change is preserved in the next generation. This is Darwin's second principle and is called the theory of natural selection. Both the theories I am going to ask you. Now, children, why? Sorry. Classification of living organisms. Correct, no? Why are living things classified? Which are the criteria used for classification of plants and animals? It is difficult to study and remember all the organisms in this diverse living world at the same time. So classification helps in this respect. Okay. Now, hierarchy of classification. Classification starts with kingdom Animalia or kingdom Plantae. Depending upon basic similarities and differences, their further groups and subgroups are formed. This is known as hierarchy of classification. Kingdom, phylum, division, class, order, family, genus, and species are the sequences of the classification system. Okay. Now, they have given here mango as a classification of kingdom Plantae, and classification of kingdom Animalia they have given human. Kingdom Plantae and Animalia, phylum Anthophylla, Chordata, class Dicotyledonae, Mammalia, order Spinidales, Primates, family Anacardiaceae, Hominidia, genus Magniferia, Homo, species Indica, Sapiens. Binomial, children, binomial nomenclature is used to identify each organism. This method was suggested by Carl Linnaeus. Every living organism has given uniform name throughout the world. This is called scientific name. Scientific name consists of two parts. The first part is genus and second species. As per the guidelines of International Code of Nomenclature, every organism has a binomial name. Two names. Only organisms belonging to the same species can produce an offspring. Only organism belonging to the same species can produce an offspring. मतलब बच्चा दे सकते हैं. All the organisms belonging to the same species may have differences in color, height, habitat, and habits, but still they can reproduce among themselves and form offsprings like themselves. Now, few examples of scientific names of the organisms. Dog, Canis lupus familiaris. Cow, Bos taurus. Hibiscus, Hibiscus rosa sinensis. Jowar, Sorghum bicolor. These are the scientific names. Year, 29th April is observed as World Frog Protection Day. According to the Wildlife Protection Act, killing or harming frogs is prohibited. Children, let's come for the exercise now. Find my match. Lotus. Answer, adapted to live in water. Aloe, adapted to live in deserts. Cascata, hostorial routes for absorption of food. Venus flytrap, flowers and leaves. Children, this read the paragraph and answer the following question. I am a penguin. I live in polar region, covered by snow. My abdomen is white. My skin is thick with a layer of fat underneath. My body is spindle shaped. My wings are small. My toes are webbed. We live in flocks. Read the paragraph and answer the following question. Now you have to answer this question. Children, I will dictate the answer. Why is my skin white and thick, and why is there a thick layer of fat underneath? Penguin lives in extremely cold polar regions. The region is always covered over with ice. It has thick skin with a thick layer of fat underneath because it does not allow the body heat to escape out. Due to white color, it can mix with the surrounding and cannot be easily located. That is why it seeks protection against predators. Next question. Why do we live in flocks, sticking close to each other? By staying in a flock, one is protected against the attack from predator. It becomes easier for parental care. Also, by sticking to each other, the body heat is not lost to the surroundings. Next, which geographical region do I inhabit? Why? Penguin stays in polar region, especially in the Antarctic region. There is abundant food available for the penguins, and thus they are seen here. Which adaptation should you have to enable you to live permanently in the polar region? Why? In order to permanently inhabit in the polar region, the body should be adapted to cold temperatures. There should be thick layer of fat and thick skin to protect the body. The ability to regulate body temperature should be extremely good for the survival. Next. Who is lying? Cockroach. I have 5 legs. Cockroach is lying. Cockroach has 6 legs. Hen. My toes are webbed. Hen is also lying. Its toes are not webbed. Cactus. My fleshy green part is a leaf. Lying. Cactus is lying. Why? Its fleshy and green part is a stem. Okay, children. Now, read each of the following statement and write a paragraph about the adaptation with reference to each statement. Children, this will be homework for you. This you will write. Got it? There is extreme heat in desert. So which adaptation, how, that you have to write. Grasslands are lush green. What kind of adaptation, why, the reason, you have to write it down. Okay? Next. Why is the camel called the sheep of the desert? Yes, children. Why is the camel called sheep of the desert? The skin of a camel is thick. The legs are long with cushioned soles. There is a fold of skin for protection of nostrils. The eyelashes are long and thick, and thus they protect the eyes. Due to all such adaptations, camel becomes more suitable to walk in a desert. That's why it is called as sheep of the desert. Okay, children. Next question. How can the plants like cactus and acacia live in deserts with scarce water? Why? The cactus and acacia are plants that grow in desert. They show adaptations to survive in the scarcity of water. Cactus does not have leaves. Leaves are modified into thorns.
Therefore, water is not lost by evaporation through leaves. The stem takes up the function of photosynthesis and hence turns fleshy and green. There is thick layer of waxy substances on the stems. Roots of these plants penetrate, means ghuste hain andar, deep down into the soil in search of water. All such adaptations help the cactus and acacia to survive in deserts with scarce water. What is the interrelationship between adaptation of organisms and their surroundings? What is the interrelationship? Adaptations are the changes that take place in the structure and function of the body. These modifications in various organs and life processes help the organisms to live, feed, reproduce, and create new generation. They also help in the protection of the organism against the predators. Depending upon the habitat and its geographical conditions, the organisms acquire corresponding adaptations. How are organisms classified? Animals and plants are classified according to their characteristics. For this, the detailed study of these organisms is done. Based on basic similarities and differences, the organisms are classified into groups and subgroups. A hierarchy is formed depending upon these features. In this way, the organisms are placed in suitable groups and classification is achieved. Children, this lesson is quite lengthy, but if you will read and understand, if you will watch this video again and again, it will be very easy to understand. Okay, here our lesson gets over. Thank you.